definitely happy that I'm not able to be here.
Amen.
Amen. I'm happy and I'm not happy. Are you happy to be here?
Glory.
Amen. I'm happy that I'm in the house of the Lord. I'm not happy that I'm sitting in this position.
Amen.
But we thank the Lord and we are just saying may His will prevail.
Hallelujah.
We believe the Lord is going to help us because it's not our ability.
Hallelujah.
If it's man's ability, it will come to naught and it will fail. Hallelujah. But we are depending on His ever sustaining ability.
Hallelujah.
So without any waste of time, let's go to a scripture reading in the book of Isaiah, chapter 32, verse 2. If you find it, it reads as follows. We're going to start from verse 1. Behold, a king shall reign in righteousness, and princes shall rule in judgment. And a man shall be as an hiding place from the wind, and a covert from the tempest, as rivers of water in a dry place, as the shadow of a great rock in a wilderness.
Amen.
And the eyes of them that see shall not be dim, and the ears of them that hear shall hearken. Let's open again the book of Revelation, chapter 3. Revelation chapter 3, verse 14. And unto the angel of the church of Laodiceans write, these things saith the Amen, the faithful and the true witness, the beginning of the creation of time. I know thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot, but thou wert cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth. Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods, and have need of nothing. And knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable, and poor and blind and naked. Mm-hmm. And you will take the comfort of the seat. May the Lord have blessed you.
Amen.
Let us approve the maker before we say amen. Lord Jesus, we thank you this wonderful morning. Lord, coming into your presence, we want the Holy Ghost to come and fill us with power, O Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Heavenly Father, when we are filled with power, we are put to action. Father God, when we have your power, we can conquer anything, Lord, under any circumstances, anyway. As Lord Jesus, every day, every hour, we, Lord, weep for your Holy Ghost, Heavenly Father. Jehovah, we pray, Lord, that as you are the vine and we are the branches, and we know that the branches depend on the life of the vine. Lord, may you re-energize us, Heavenly Father, with the life of the Holy Ghost, Father God, so that we can bear much more fruits, Jehovah. We appreciate you this morning, even myself, O Lord, being a mere man, full of mistakes, full of weaknesses. Lord Jesus, I don't want anyone to look, O Lord, to me, but I want them to look through me and see your spirit,
amen.
Father God, and they will be helped because they will be hearing from you.
Hallelujah.
Lord, we know the greatest stumbling block, Father, is this flesh. Father God, that's why, Lord Jesus, we have to look at one another beyond the flesh.
Yes, Lord.
We pray, Jehovah, that may you come and minister to the needs of your children. You know them by heart.
Amen.
You know, Father, by names. You know, Heavenly Father, even the number of hair on every individual.
Yes, Lord.
Jehovah, no man has attempted to do that, but Father, because you created the man, Father, you know all those things. Even this morning, may you look into their hearts and see their needs and address them accordingly, Father. Jesus, let me dedicate every soul into your hands and capture every spirit under our control.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We just want to greet you once again. We are happy to see you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
some already went to holidays. I know we're like, I'm surprised to see Braputi. He'll be gone also. This movie was actually next week.
Oh.
So the Lord is blessed you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are not our kids are in the home. They are having good time on that side. And we thank God for this trip. You realize that they are much more blessed than you think.
Amen.
You know, and you don't realize how mature they are, you know, until one day they just say something that just catches.
Hallelujah.
On Thursday evening, I was talking to my boy. He's using his cousin's phone, my younger sister's child's phone. So he's asking me, "Daddy, how are you? I don't know if I'm going to tell." Then I said, "I'm fine." Then he's asking me, "Hey, I miss you." That side. I said, "Hey, we miss you too. And you must come back. Can I come and fetch you the weekend?" He said, "No, the weekend is too soon." I said to him, "Yeah, but you miss us and we miss you. So, plus the dogs miss you. There's no one to clean after their waste, you know." He said, "Oh, no, if that is the case, I must come back next year." So then now I had to cut him off and say, "Hey, Daddy's preparing for tomorrow. Tomorrow, Daddy's going to preach. Because on Friday, we were talking at the youth camp there with the youth. So I said, "Hey, Daddy's preparing for tomorrow, so we will talk." Then he says, "Okay, no, I'll pray with you that you become a blessing to the children of God."
Amen.
So that really humbled me. You don't expect that from me. It's a little bit reserved individual. So you don't realize that maturity, especially if they don't talk a lot.
Yeah.
Then in my mind, I'm thinking, it means if you say, "I'm going to pray with you that you become a blessing to the children of God," it means you always do that.
Yes.
I guess it's not the first time you're starting.
Yeah.
So then I realize we are really privileged, we really thank the Lord that we can help these children be born under the atmosphere of God, you know, growing under the atmosphere of God. So as parents, whatever we do, we must try to remain under the way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The influence of the way. The way we run our homes, it should be guided by the way. The way we treat our wives, the way we treat one another, it should be guided by the way.
Hallelujah.
Because the moment we leave the influence of the way in our day-to-day running of lives, then we are just set for disaster. So may the Lord help us. Amen.
Amen.
So we just want to take a thought here that says, the escalating pressure of Laodicea. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Escalating pressure of Laodicea. And for the inspiration, we just want to say that sustained by the purpose. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
The last time I preached, I think I preached a message. The appearance of the Lord is the peace in a believer's heart. Then I said, "We're going to finish it off." But it's fine, I'm inspired differently this morning, and we will finish it off next year.
Amen.
We will never finish this message.
Hallelujah.
And we are still together, so we're still going to have a lot of preachings to come.
Yes.
Amen.
So we realize that the time we are living in one of the most great and horrible ages. Hallelujah. It is a great age because supernatural has happened in this time.
Yes,
you know, this is the time where the prophets looked and they desired to be in this time. You know, the Abraham, the Isaiah, the David, you know, all of them, they desired to be in this time. Because this is the time where the heavens are open and God has come down and is making love to his wife. Hallelujah.
Amen.
How is God making love to his wife? He's locked in secret closets, you know, fellowshipping with the wife.
Hallelujah.
Revealing himself to the wife, making mysteries known to the wife. Hallelujah. Because the husband does not, a man does not just tell secrets to every girl that he comes across. Hallelujah. He does not tell his plans to every girl that he meets on the road. Amen. He only tells the detailed plan to the person that is going to spend the rest of life with.
Hallelujah.
So this is the time we're living in. The floodgates of heaven are open and blessings are just showering upon the bride. Amen. Or also is the most horrible time because of the floodgates of hell also are open. And the demons are out to receive to it that the children of God fail. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we thank God because God will make sure that the child of God does not fail. The bride can never fail. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is a promise that the bride will never fail. Because the God says in the book of Revelation, for the bride has made herself ready.
Amen.
So someone who's ready is someone who's ready to take off. Someone who's ready is someone who's prepared.
Yes.
And he must have read the material to prepare.
Hallelujah.
Which is the revelation of the way. Hallelujah. Amen. So no matter what the devil throws at us, we cannot fail.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So we realize that the devil, what he's doing is using pressure. Hallelujah. Amen. Now pressure sounds like a bad thing, but pressure, it can be a good thing. Hallelujah. Because
Amen.
Only under pressure you see the potential of something.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Even the true nature and behavior of people, you see it when they're under pressure. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When there's no pressure, everyone is wonderful, everyone is loving, everyone is caring. Just put a little bit of fire there.
Yeah.
Put a little bit of pressure. Then you will see and you will hear things you never had before.
Hallelujah.
So every Christian needs pressure so that certain things in your life can be exposed.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, those who train will understand, you'll understand that for a muscle to grow, it has to go under tension and pressure.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. So the quality of growth is dependent on how long the muscle has been under pressure. Amen. So when you put a muscle under pressure, you are changing the muscle fiber, yet you are preparing it for growth. You are preparing it for growth.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. So when the muscle fibers breaks, then they are prepared for growth.
Amen.
Then they recover and come together bigger and stronger. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you realize that the same thing happens spiritually.
Amen.
When pressure comes, at times it tears you and breaks you, but it just prepares you for growth.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we should be appreciating pressure. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we hear that Brother Branham already in 1962, he looked at down the age and he saw the time we're living in, he preached already about letting up of pressure. Because he saw the amount of pressure that will be accumulated in the time we're living in.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Brother Branham preached four messages about letting up pressure.
Amen.
62, he preached 3, 63, he preached 1. Amen. Now you realize that the time Brother Branham was living or was still alive, there was not pressure like today.
Amen.
You know, the internet was not the same as it is today. Advancement of technology was not as it is today.
Exactly.
Hallelujah. I mean, now technology, we are moving in what we call decentralized technology.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Where no one is owning it, but it is just decentralized.
Amen.
So everyone can do whatever they want on the blockchain.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
That's
how far we have come. We went from world wide web. One and two.
Amen.
So now there's a third layer that is built upon the second one, which is the third one, which is they call it a blockchain technology. A few of you will understand that. But then it's a decentralized where financial systems can be built upon it, where they can already be with that project. I think it's Uganda, where when you're born, they take your genes and record them in the blockchain. They can never be deleted for generations. Never be deleted. Now when you're born, your particulars are in the records of the computer at the hospital. So should the computer crash or should the file be stolen, then everything disappears. You see, your things at home affairs, should the file be lost, then they cannot be tracked. So that technology, it goes as far as everyone whose genes are recorded there, is they're going to live forever.
Amen.
So that's how far technology has come. So you realize that things are just advancing. You know, back then, there used to be cars that were driving maximum speed of 20 kilometers per hour.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Now we're having cars that are driving 300 and something kilometers per hour.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yet, when Einstein wanted to prove the theory, he said, if a car drives that speed, it will take off. They made it to drive that speed and remain on the ground.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So that's how far the advancement has come.
Amen.
But you realize that as this advancement of technology is appearing and is being developed, you realize that also God is busy with his children.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As the pressure is mounting among the children of God, also God is busy with the children of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because we are living in Laodicea, and we know that Laodicea is one of the seven church ages. It's the seventh of the seven church ages. I wish I had something to write. I want to talk to him.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You know, if you go and look at the book of Revelation from chapter 1 to, or rather, chapter 3. These are church ages, right? Now, these church ages, they are physical location. And all these church ages, they are time constrained.
Amen.
Amen.
They've got the beginning and they've got the end.
Amen.
And Brother Brian teaches us that everything that has the beginning must have the end. So they will come to an end. Hallelujah. And they are situated physically in Asia Minor. Hallelujah. So now, where they're situated is cities, by the way. They are named after cities. Now, that's why we are seeing they are physically located. Let's put it correctly so that no one misunderstands. The church ages in the Bible is that named after the cities
Amen.
That are in Asia.
Amen.
Is it clear now?
Amen.
And these cities are physically located.
Amen.
I don't want any misunderstandings.
Amen.
So now, if you look at these cities, they're like this. They're not far from one another. Right? Just like this. Seven of them. Then there's an ocean here, and there's a Mediterranean Sea.
Amen.
Somewhere here, there's another sea here. There's another small island here called an island of Patmos. Amen. So now you realize that this church ages that God named the dispensation of generations according to them that physically located in Asia. So we are living on the seventh one here, which is Laodicea. Laodicea. We know the first one is Ephesus. The second one? Smyrna. The third one?
Pergamos.
The fifth one? The fifth one, Sardis.
Philadelphia.
The seventh one? Laodicea. So, all these church ages are very important. You see, good that you're back. God bless you. So, Laodicea. Now, Laodicea is the last one. And every one of these churches, they have prophets, right? We know that the prophets of Ephesians was Paul. Was Paul. The last one, Brother Branham. Right? Brother Branham. Hallelujah. So, with these church ages, we have the seven church ages, we've got where Brother Branham preached a bridge. And he preached simplicity. Got him? Simplicity. Then he preaches now the seven seals. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, the church ages, we said they are named after physical location. Right? Cities.
Amen.
The church ages, they are time constrained. Yeah. Time constrained. Which the effect of the church ages is flesh. We're going to explain it. Now, we've got the seven seals this side. We've got bridge here. We've got the going simplicity. Then we've got the seven seals. Now, in the seven seals, we see the operation of these seals in the church ages.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because now, the seal, Brother Bram says, a seal speaks of finished work.
Amen.
A seal speaks of ownership. Hallelujah. And now, we know that the Bible speaks about first, second, third, until the seventh one.
Amen.
And we know that the Brother comes and preaches them according to that sequence.
Amen.
But we know they don't happen according to that sequence.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Because right the time we are living in the sixth seal
for example, already started operating.
Yes.
You know, God is showing signs already in the heavens.
Amen.
You know, the nature responding in different places in diverse manners.
Hallelujah.
So it's already in operation, the sixth seal, but we know the culminate of the sixth seal is when now the bride is raptured and persecution, full persecution or tribulation comes to the people that rejected God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The bride will be there when that happens.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now we've got the seals. Now a seal speaks of a finished work. Rabban says in another, in God in simplicity, say a seal speaks of ownership. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, in the seals, when the first seal is open, we see a white horse.
Amen.
Now, a white horse represents power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, this represents now a spirit. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
A spirit. Now, we know that a spirit does not affect the flesh, but it affects the soul. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But now for the spirit to affect the soul, it has to deal with the flesh. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now that's why you see all these spirits that are revealed in the seven seals, they operate in the 17 ages. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now the purpose of operating in the 17 ages, we do not know that until Brother Brandon preached these things.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So let us make a disclaimer that this is not our own revelation, it's Brother Brennan's revelation.
I know
God gave it. It's ours that he revealed it to us and we own it.
Amen.
But it's not us who discovered these things.
Yes. Yes. Amen.
So there's no minister who discovered things. The Brother Brennan was given revelation and he preached it to us.
Amen.
And we are just echoing what he said. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
That's right.
So we realize that these spirits, they operate in the church ages. And they operate in the church ages to bring pressure to the flesh.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when pressure comes to the flesh, then your soul gets discouraged.
Amen.
Then your soul gets sad. Hallelujah. Because we know that the flesh is time restrained. The flesh is location constrained. Because we know that when we die here, this flesh is going back to the ground.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So that's why the devil, when he comes to you, the devil does not come to you as a supernatural being. He comes to you with the afflictions of the flesh.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. That's why Brother Brown says, this flesh can never be born again.
Yes.
Amen. This flesh can never be born again. Even your spirit changes now and then.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. But what is born again is your soul. That's why Jesus comes and says, we have passed from death into eternity, into life.
Amen.
Why? Because of not in your flesh, you're still here.
Amen.
But you have passed, you have crossed from death, from flesh, from time into life. That has happened in your soul. But what influences that is the spirit that comes from the revelation of the seals.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, in the revelation of the seals, we receive four powers, four spirits.
Amen.
Going forth to the church ages and operating the church ages.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Mm. And this four spirits, we see the last one, the first one being white horse rider, red horse rider, black one, the fourth one being a pale. A pale one is operating in the Laodicea.
Mm.
Right?
Amen.
Which is combination of the other three.
Yes.
The other three, white in the first two churches, red, second one, black, the last two. Now on the seventh one is the pale one.
Amen.
Which Brother Brent teaches that is the combination of the other three. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you see what we're going through, children of God, the pressure we're experiencing today as children of God comes from the combination of powers.
Amen. Amen.
So powers has amalgamated, has combined to be one so that they can bring a child of God to discouragement.
Mm.
Hallelujah. But we realize that when that is happening, the purpose of God is sustaining us.
Amen.
The program says we are sustained by the purpose of God.
Amen.
Before I continue, let me just read that. It's something wonderful.
Amen.
Brother Graham, in the message, I know my Redeemer liveth, he says, and if we were put here for a purpose, then there's nothing can destroy us until God's purpose is fulfilled.
Amen.
Amen.
He says, nothing can harm us until that purpose that God has put us here for. has been made manifest. No matter how much trouble we have, how much headaches we have, sorrow that we go through, all these are reasons. And there's a reason for it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So whatever a Christian goes through, Brother Bram says there's a reason for that.
Hallelujah.
He says the devil cannot touch you until your purpose is fulfilled.
Yes.
And God does not just do things. God do things according to plan and his purpose. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I mean, when God plans it, if as a byproduct, there was a purpose for that.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. And you might hear someone say, but how would he create a man to be a woman, to be weak, blah, blah, blah. God had a purpose.
Yes.
I mean, God even created the devil and he had a purpose for that.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So everything that God did, he had a purpose. There was a reason and a purpose why the children of Israel went in the wilderness for 40 years instead of 4 days.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Imagine all the skeptics, the mourners, the unbelievers that would have been in the promised land.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And in the promised land, there was no space for such tendencies. Because in the promised land, that's where they were to wear authority and speak the word and claim the land that was given to them.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. But imagine all those mourners and mamaras. And we should not be mourners and mamaras.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
Hallelujah. I think it's Paul in the book of Philippians. He said, do nothing in murmuring and dispute.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because murmuring and dispute has what we call ripple effect. Ripple effect is waves, is a sense of waves that is caused by a breeze in the sea. Now, what happened is that you start by mourning, right? Let's say you do the children of God. They went out of promised land being joyous, being happy, you know, applied the blood, came everything, thanking God for the Savior Moses, having faith in Moses because they saw what God did through Moses. After they went out, the first challenge that they got, they started murmuring.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The first challenge that they got, there was the Red Sea in front, there was mountains and Pharaoh's armies were approaching.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. But Abraham says, one looks at it, he says, God is a poor military strategist.
Mm-hmm.
He says he just led them as a commander through the ambush of the devil.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So, for the first time, you would hear them first right there complaining.
Yeah.
And murmuring. Is that innocent? Yeah, Moses is brought here to that. Look at the soldiers of Pharaoh and all those things. Then God comes and says, why can I speak?
Amen.
The Egyptian you see shall see them no more.
Yes.
And they went through. And they rejoiced, they are happy, they overcame. The Egyptians they saw, they see them no more, they are joyous. Then there was Moses and they now, is that this mama innocent?
Mm-hmm.
Then they say, you see Moses think, you think God speaks only to him. Even God can speak through us.
Yeah.
So we want God to speak directly to us. It has escalated from murmuring to God speaking through us. Hallelujah. And God sorted that out very quickly. And it went from that to, but we can have our own gods also. Let us make our own God, a graven God and worship it. And they did that. But where did it start? Murmuring. So murmuring and complaining and dispute, it builds up and affects other avenues. That's why we say it has ripple effects.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. So let us be careful of that. Amen.
Amen.
So God, everything that he does it for a purpose. He allowed them to go through the Red Sea so that they can have faith in him and see that he can open the sea. So that he can see that there's nothing impossible to God. Hallelujah. He allowed them to go into a dry land so that they can realize that God is possible to do anything and everything.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He allowed them purposefully. He made sure that they go into a dry land before the water so that he can make sure that the water comes from the rock and show them that I'm God and I'm capable of doing anything. So it doesn't matter what a Christian's circumstances is. Brother says God does not lead you to that circumstance for nothing. He says he's got a purpose with you. Hallelujah. Brother says even death cannot hold us. He says even death cannot hold us. He says it doesn't matter, we've got gray hair, we've got wrinkles, with some of us are going to have a dance time and we are coming gray hair. He says even if you can have wrinkles and get old, he says death won't hold you. When you go through that grave, when you come back the same way you went to the altar with those feet out. Hallelujah. Amen. We'll be young again. Amen.
Amen.
So God's purpose can never be defeated. God's purpose is holding us, children of God. So let us just remember that. Now,
everything that God does, we said it has a purpose. So there's a reason I marked also Patmos of Island, Island of Patmos. There was a man called John the Liberator. He was captured saying that he's a witch. They took him here and they boiled him. Before that, they took him here, they boiled him for 24 hours in a drum of grease, saying that he's a witch. Nothing happened. They said, now it's confirmed. This guy is a witch. We are taking you here to Isle of Patmos. Here, it is a place where they were taking hardcore criminals that were sentenced to death. So you go in, you don't come back. It's a complete non-return journey. Hallelujah. So when he went here, that's when now God started using him. Hallelujah. So you realize that God is the one who led him here.
Amen.
And it must have been an unpleasant journey. Imagine, children of God, remember we have this attitude that we are saving God, everything should be smooth. Everything should be wonderful. We should not suffer. You know, we should not struggle. But you realize that the people that God performed great things with, they went through suffering. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So it must have been a tough journey for John the Revelator. So when John went here, when he got there, God said, come up higher.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. We were telling the youth on Friday that for God to do anything in your life or for you to be a powerful Christian, you need to live high. Amen. Hallelujah. So that's why God said to John, come up higher.
Amen.
Amen. That's why also in the army, you realize that in the army, when we fight or when we lay an ambush, we look for higher ground.
Amen.
Even when we build a camp, the first thing we look is for higher ground. All military camps are situated on the higher ground. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Especially in the operational areas. Amen. So when a sniper also takes a position, amen, he takes a higher ground. He goes to the mountains, he goes to the tree, whatever, most of the time the mountains go higher ground. So there's no sniper that goes to the flat surface or the sloping surface and start taking position. Why? Two things. There's a reason for that. The reason we choose higher ground is because when you are in higher ground, your view is broader. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
Your area of vision is narrowed and your view is broader. So you cover bigger space. Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
In the military times, the reason we go to higher ground is because the trajectory of a projectile, it slopes when it travels. So now, if you are on a flat surface, it will travel shorter than when you're on a higher ground. So higher ground accelerate the speed of the projectile. Projectile is just the front part of the bullet, the round. It faster the speed of projectile. And when you're at a higher ground, your vision is good. It means that your round, your projectile will travel even longer distance.
Yes.
Than when a flat surface. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So a Christian should think in those lines. He should always be in higher ground, you know, under the atmosphere of the word of God.
Amen.
So that when the enemy comes, you know, he's higher than the enemy. You'll see him from there.
Amen.
Say, oh, that is the devil.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because you are always in the atmosphere of the word of God. You're still in higher ground. You'll speak like Paul and say, we are not ignorant of the devices of the devil.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You'll see them from far. But if you're not in the atmosphere of the word of God, I'm telling you, you'll fall on every trap of the devil.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yeah. So you realize that even the Elijah, when he challenged the prophets of Baal, he took them to the mountains.
Amen.
Higher ground.
That's right.
Hallelujah. When David was challenging the Philistines, they were at the mountains. Go in your Bible, in the book of is it Kings?
Yeah.
Yeah, First Kings. They were at the mountains.
Amen.
And then he said, come. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. When Brother Branham, when God revealed the seven seals to Brother Branham, where did he take him to? The mountains.
Amen.
And Dr. Brother Branham comes and preached, what is the attraction on the mountain?
Amen.
Amen. Because there's something about higher ground. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we realize that even snipers, they take position on the higher ground.
Mm-hmm.
Now snipers, they go in pairs.
Mm-hmm.
It's two. There's a spotter and there's a sniper, the one who turns to the shooting. Now, this one who spot, he's got a wider binoculars.
Amen.
Those binoculars most of the time are digital.
Mm.
So they calculate the speed of the wind, they calculate the humidity, they calculate even the distance between the sniper and the possible target.
So he used to identify that and calculate that and tell the sniper. And the sniper just released a shot. Hallelujah. And when the enemy comes, so this man who is a spotter, he's as good as a sniper. He's also a sniper, he can shoot. They did the same thing. They just switch at times. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So this one that is a sniper, his side by looking on the weapon is narrow. So he's focused on the current target. But this one who's a spotter, his view is broader. So he can tell him that there's an enemy coming 100 meters, 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. There's another thing here. Hey, he's coming to the left. Go to the left, go to the left. Shoot to the left, shoot to the left. Bro, you must know your story there.
Amen.
You know, yeah. Enemy, 100 meters, 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
So the sniper knows that he looks at 11 o'clock. Because on a stimulus like this, it's your 12 o'clock, it's your 3, it's your 9. So 100 meters, 11 o'clock, you know, he takes his eyes to the 100 meters, 11 o'clock. Then he shoots. So now, here's the thing. The spotter is one of the most important people in coming to that mission. Very important. So the life and the effectiveness of a sniper is dependent on the spotter.
Mm.
Praise be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So you realize that, let's take an example, you realize that when David was facing Goliath, he had a stone. He had a screenshot. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I'm sure as he was swinging that screenshot, because that screenshot, children of God, it hit Pharaoh here on the forehead. Right?
Amen.
That stone.
Amen.
So it was, there was supernatural power,
yes,
in that stone. So I'm sure as he was swinging that screenshot, the spotter being God himself, because God's God by looking at that brother, the sniper himself.
Amen.
God was saying, David, 300 meters.
Yes.
Then David set the sights. 300 meters. David, humility, what?
Right.
David says, I'm ready. David, the wind is traveling at what kilometers per hour. Oh, he said, I'm ready. So you must shoot to your left so that that stone can swing like this.
Mm-hmm.
When Goliath ducks with him and all those things. So you realize that stone, when David released it, there was a supernatural guidance on that stone.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, Goliath was a giant. He must have seen that stone coming.
Amen.
And he must have tried to duck and go left and go up and down, but he just saw that stone following him.
Amen.
As he go up and down, left and right, following him until it hit him here. Hallelujah.
Yes.
So
hallelujah.
Children of God, we must allow God to be the spotter in our lives.
Amen.
Because he sees things that we don't see.
Amen.
He knows things that we don't know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we must allow him to be the spotter.
Amen.
You are the sniper. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You've got a sniping rifle with you. Amen.
Amen.
Which is the word itself.
Amen.
Or we can say in this instance, which is faith. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The rifle in this instance, in this example, is faith. And upon that faith, there's two sides, which is the word and the spoken word.
Amen.
They must be aligned with the faith. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So when spotter says target 300 meters, 12 o'clock, you just squeeze faith within the confines of the word, it will hit the target.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And now there come a time where this spotter can become a sniper.
Amen.
And a sniper become a spotter.
Amen.
That's why God says, whatever you say, if you say to this mountain, move, it shall come to pass.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That's why Brother says, in this time, the bride is the final way.
Hallelujah. Amen.
So now the bride is the one that speaks and things happen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's why there was a time Moses was a spotter, God as a sniper.
Amen.
God wanted to destroy the children of Israel, Moses being the spotter, he being a brother too at that time.
Yeah.
He says, but if you do that, the wind does not allow. The target. The wind does not allow God. People are going to laugh at us. They're going to say, you took your children out to destroy them. Moses advising God this time.
Mm-hmm.
And God says, yeah, my spotter, you are right. Nah.
Mm-hmm.
Because he listened to him.
Amen.
He listened to Moses. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we have to realize, children of God, that everything happens by God's purpose.
Hallelujah.
And the purpose of God sustains us. We're going to read a quote. There's a wonderful quote about purpose. It sustains us. So here, we see that there are spirits that went and operate in the church ages. And the seventh one being Laodicea, we know Laodicea means human rights.
Amen.
And we know that one of the things, before Laodicea, let me come here just to make another point. Here when God addressed the church of Ephesians, There's something that he hated there. There was something called the deeds of Nicolaitans. The deeds of Nicolaitan, Brother Branham, when he explains those deeds, the deeds of the word Nicolaitan is a Greek word. What they call it?
Conquer the late.
Sorry? They call it, there's a word for it.
They call it the
Podmetas. Yeah. It's one word that derives from two words. Podmetas.
Okay.
Yeah. If I'm pronouncing it right. Something like that. So Nicolaitan from a branch teaches us that it's a combination of two words. Nikau and the lighting. To conquer the lighting. So children of God, this spirit of Nicolaitan did not die out yet. It is still here in the Laodicea church age, even worse.
Yes.
Because remember, pale horse is a combination of all these powers. So all these powers that operated in the church ages, you will find them here in Laodicea. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Death in Laodicea. The devil wants to finish you off.
Amen.
Spirit of white horse, Nicolaitan to conquer the lighting in Laodicea. The devil comes innocently to you. Innocent things. Can't he know that he's finishing you off?
Amen.
Destroying you. Don't worry about this, it's a minor thing. Don't worry about this, it's a minor thing. Innocent. Destroying you. Death, you want to just finish you off. Red horse rider. Black horse rider. He comes with the effect of economics.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because we know that under the black horse or the red horse, there was economics, there was selling, there was exchanging there. Hallelujah. So he comes with that, he comes to you and give you financial problems. What is the purpose? The purpose is one, is just to finish you off.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We had a career session with the youth there. Yeah, we had a career session and we were talking about finances, we were talking about careers, we were talking about discipline and all of those things. So I said something there. Did I say that scripture? Yeah, there's a scripture in the book of Proverbs 22 where it says the rich will rule over the poor. And it continues on and says the borrower is a servant to the lender.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So now those scriptures are not lying.
Hallelujah.
Tell me which country have ever seen a poor man ruling. Scriptures will never lie. Hallelujah. So you realize that scriptures, they will tell you the correct truth. And you realize that all of us, because we are poor, we are servants to the lender. I'm going to go to the bank. The bank borrow me money, I want to buy a car.
Amen.
Then they borrow you money. Borrow me money, I want to buy a house. They borrow you money. Give me a credit card, they give you a credit card. Borrow me money, I want to renovate my house. They do that. So they are lending you. Then you end up being a servant because when you get paid, all the pay goes to the bank. Hallelujah. That's why the other time I made a statement, I said, we own nothing here. This thing, if the bank decides to take them to all of these cars, they can take them.
Amen.
Is that. So we become servants to the lender. Amen. So that while children of God, we must try by all means to be the lenders.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We must try by all means to be the lenders. Amen. Now Jesus in the book of I'm just detouring now, but I'm passing. Yes. I think even us elderly people, we need career guidance.
Hallelujah.
We need career discussions because I think some of the mistakes that we made, we wouldn't have made if we had guidance.
Hallelujah.
You know, Jesus comes and he gives a parable of a talent. He says he took three people. One he gave one talent, one talent, one talent. Then they left, they went to cry them. The third one did not do anything, he buried it. And when Jesus comes, the other one says, I multiply it. He said, the master comes to the land, he says, I multiply it. Thank you. Master said, you did well. You did well. I'm even going to give you more.
Amen.
Then the second one, you did well. Wise steward, I'm going to give you more. Then the other one comes and take that money and bury it. When the master comes, he goes and buries it. He says, Master, me, I did not take your money. I did not take your money. That money, that talent, did he says it was. Then he calls him two ways. He said, those ways they moved me.
Amen.
I thought a lot about that. He calls him two ways. He said, you wicked and slothful. You know when you're slothful, you are lazy.
Yeah.
Even to think. You are just lazy. Wicked and slothful. You know what? Take even this one, give it to the rich.
Yeah.
The one who multiplied the bread.
Amen.
I said, Lord, help us with this little money that you give us, you know, salary, being whatever, being an income, to go and multiply it.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Because I'm sure sometimes God is just aggravated when he sees us, you know, becoming just a servant to the lenders. But we are not putting any effort to multiply the talents he gave us.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. So I think that God must really help us.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So Brother Moni, interpret that verse or say something on it. He says, any man who takes money and puts it in the pocket is stupid.
Yeah.
In the Message Investment. Any man who takes money and puts it in the pocket is stupid.
Hallelujah. Amen.
So it means that it is supposed to be used to multiply that money. So may the Lord help us. These scriptures are for a purpose and they are there for our learning. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So now we realize that now in this Laodicea, we said it's four powers, all of them combined. But as there were spirits of the devil released to operate there, there were also spirits and powers released to go and amplify and strengthen and fortify the children of God. There were four spirits that were released. It was the face of a man.
Amen.
Ox or calf, ne?
Yes.
No, lion. Brothers, how do I call it? Lion, face of a man, and eagle. Hallelujah. So now these spirits were also released to come and operate here on the side of the children of God. Remember, the Bible says when the devil comes like a flood, God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now this spirit, each spirit they operated like that one of the devil in the two church ages.
Yes.
Then the seventh church age, we find the spirit of an eagle.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now an eagle, we know it's a bit of height.
Hallelujah.
As we're speaking about higher ground, an eagle does not take the enemy and destroy the enemy here. An eagle takes the enemy and go to the mountains, higher ground.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And start fighting the enemy there. You know, release the snake, you hit him against the rocks and all those things. So we have that spirit of an eagle to fly above everything, the dark and all the things that Laodicea throws at us.
Mm-hmm.
But not only do we have that spirit, I believe, this is me, I believe as the devil's spirits are combined to be strong, I believe we have a combination of all these spirits also.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And I'm going to tell you why I believe that. The first spirit, which is the face of a lion in the dispensation of Paul, where he was just cutting everything. We have that spirit.
Amen.
Where you cut everything that is against sin.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Where you, there are things that you don't play with them. There are things that you implement very strong.
Mm.
Hallelujah. Face of a lion. And there are times where people speak things against you and you just bear.
Amen.
You hear your neighbor saying this against you, you bear with them. Even your brothers in the church, you bear with them.
Amen.
Even your friends, you bear with them.
Amen.
That's the ox spirit, the animal of waking, the animal of burden. You can load it, I don't know how many kgs of weight, it will cancel and it will work until sunset.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But not only that, but we've got the spirit of the face of a man. Remember, the spirit of the face of a man, it speaks about wisdom.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It speaks about wisdom. So we have wisdom to say certain things and not say certain things. We have wisdom to put things in a certain way. We have wisdom to lead our families, run our families, make decisions. Because the message of the hour is wisdom of the day.
Hallelujah.
So it's guiding us day to day running of our lives. And decision making. That's why I believe that if there's wisest people on the face of the earth, today's message delivers.
Amen. Amen.
It's not your professors, it's not your doctors, it's not people who have MBAs, but it's your message delivers. The people who believe what's said this day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the Bible says the first wisdom is to fear
of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So if wisdom is given a qualification, doctors, then message believers are all doctors.
Amen.
Then we should address one another as Dr. Puti. God bless you, Dr. Puti.
Hallelujah. So now you tell us that these spirits are amplified in one. So there's no way that we can succumb to the presence of Laodicea. Hallelujah. Because we've got the combination of the spirits that come from the throne of God.
Amen.
In Revelation chapter 4, those spirits, they come from the throne of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We cannot succumb to the pressures of money. We cannot succumb to the pressures of losing this, of not achieving this, of not doing this. Because we've got the Spirit of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you realize that Brother Branham says, people are just so in living under pressure. I'm going to read a quote here. Abraham says in Message Learning of Pressure 1963, he says, and we are living in day of much pressure. Everywhere, everybody is so tense. And down the street with the hot rod, and they can't wait for the stoplight. And you know, and run over you. And they're not going anywhere.
Sorry.
Not at all, not going anywhere. So you see, everyone is just so pressured up, they're just so short-tempered. They are just so in a hurry. You know, you see from driving, and they swear a lot when people drive bad.
Amen.
You know, everyone is just so in pressure. The mood is just in pressure. So you realize that a Christian should build himself to live in an atmosphere of God.
Amen.
That's why before you go out of your house, you should be praying.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why before you should wake up in the morning and lead the way.
Amen.
Spend time with God alone. Hallelujah. Not to jigalela alone, just make yourself. It doesn't matter, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, but just make it a routine.
Just
spending time with God.
Hallelujah.
You realize that when you go out there to face these pressures, pressures of this earth, then that will just sustain you. You realize that you are calm in situations where you don't know how you remain calm.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But brother, I'm telling you, don't do it. You'll find pointing fingers there. You'll find on the street pointing people with fingers. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So we don't want such behaviors. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We want to remain under the atmosphere of the word of God. When the presence of this time comes, then we remember that, we are just living under presence of the Spirit.
Yes.
Not throughout this year.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It's the pale horse. Amen. So we have better spirit. We have higher calls, a higher calling that is empowered by the Spirit.
Amen.
That comes from the throne of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the cry is very important that everyone should have the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Praise be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I just want to read something here. Children of God, I'm telling you, the purpose of God is sustaining us.
Amen.
It's not our ability that is sustaining us.
Hallelujah.
If we are put here for a purpose, then there's nothing can destroy us until God's purpose is fulfilled.
Amen.
Nothing can harm us until that purpose that God has put us here for has been made manifest. No matter how much trouble we have, how much headaches or sorrows that we go through, all of these are reasons, and there's a reason for it. We will take, for instance, Noah in the Bible. There was a flood that came, and all the earth was destroyed, and vegetation, and everything was destroyed, but Noah and the seed that he had taken into the ark. You see, God's purpose can never be defeated. There's nothing can defeat it. So, how happy ought we to be today, resting upon the beautiful revelation of the word of the living God?
Amen.
That there is neither things present, nor things that can come. There's no sickness, there's no sorrow, there's no death, there's no perils. No, nothing can separate us from the purpose of the living God.
Hallelujah.
Do you hear this, children of God?
Amen.
There's no sorrow, there's no sickness, there's no perils. There's nothing can separate us from the purpose of the living God.
Amen.
There's no sickness, there's no discouragement, there's no poverty. There's nothing that can discourage us
from
the purpose of the living God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Not even
old age, not even death, not even sickness. Nothing can discourage us. But nothing can separate us, rather, from the purpose of the living God.
Hallelujah.
Children of God, we are highly favored.
Amen.
We are highly loved. As Brother Branham says here, Brother Branham says in the message, the bridge between church ages and seals, Brother Branham says, God took Adam and made him God of earth. And God was the God of heavens. So God was governing the heavens, Adam was governing the earth. So now what the mistake that the Adam did is that Adam traded or exchanged faith with, I must just say this one correct, with doubts. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says he traded faith with doubt. He says, but when God created a man, he was to govern here on the earth. So that's why you see when the devil comes and attack you with things that are earthly. Because when God created the man, he meant us to live here on earth.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's why you see when we go to our new home, our new home is not going to be in some heaven somewhere. Our new home is going to be a renewed earth. Because from the beginning, when God created a man, he created him in such a manner. That's why you're not going to live in some type of mysterious bodies, but it will be a glorified body.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Right here on earth.
Amen.
Because if it's here on earth, it means to be in a position to contact the earth.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Praise be the name of the Lord. So children of God, let us remember that we've got a purpose.
Yes.
And the purpose of God cannot be defeated.
Hallelujah.
The purpose of God in our lives is that we should overcome this age. Brother says, God brought us here to show the devil that we are victors.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He brought us here to show him that we are great.
Amen.
Brother says, what is greatness? Greatness is simplicity.
Yes.
Amen. He said, what makes God great is that he can come himself, he can come down and be simple and reveal himself in simplicity.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So when this spirit comes, they come to take us out of this church age that is affecting our flesh and all those things and bring us right here into who we are.
Amen.
Because at the revelation of the seals is when we know who we are. When we track back our genealogy. When we track back our future, foresee our future. Hallelujah. So now what happens is that when God revealed the seals to us, then we are elevated out of Laodicea. So we might be here in Laodicea by flesh, but in our soul we are elevated.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That's why we can say thou art naked. That's why we can look at the people and say, hey, people are naked, they're not dressing.
Yeah.
Because we don't have that spirit of nakedness of Laodicea.
Hallelujah.
So in a way, if you look at it in another manner, rapture is in motion.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah. The start of process of rapture has started already.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So every day when you read the word, when you pray, when you read the word, when you pray, it means that you are processing the process of rapture in your life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because your faith is building. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your body is building, spiritual body, or your faith body is building stronger every day as you eat.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And one of these days, you're going to break in out of this body completely.
Hallelujah.
In the kingdom of an eye. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And be raptured. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So let us remember, children of God, God's purpose can never be defeated.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Remember that one all time, at all times.
Amen.
As we're closing, let's just close with this one.
Amen.
The purpose of God can never be defeated.
Hallelujah.
He is sustaining us. The escalation of pressure this Laodicea cannot discourage us.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brother Branham says, I'm going to read quickly, I just said it paraphrasing it. But Abraham says, and here was Moses and Israel right in the land of duty, pillar of fire leading them, and led them right down into the trap. Do you hear that, children of God?
Amen.
pillar of fire leading the children of Israel, yet led them into the trap. So when a child of God has gone into a trap, that really does not have the host. When a child of God goes through things, does not mean he does not have the Holy Ghost. What has left him? We live up to our promises. Leading them right down into a trap. God likes to get his people in traps. See what they will do. Every son that comes to God must first be tried and tested. He gets them there, he brings you here. He put you between opinions. Now, could that be mental telepathy? Could it be? See, he put you in a trap to see what kind of decision you are going to make. That's right. Search the scriptures. Jesus said, they are they that testify of me. That's right. Now, God, let it get that way. Now, he brought Israel into a trap. Mountain and desert, both sides, Pharaoh's army pursuing, thousands of chariots and spears, and bunch of humble little poor slaves not armed with nothing.
Amen.
Come down to the Dead Sea or the Red Sea rather, down there in its banks, and here was the dust of chariots coming, and there was mountain on either side. Now look like God was a bad military man.
Hallelujah.
Left his people with no retreat. Isn't it what they were saying in the Dark Ages? That God is cruel. How can he let his people be killed like flies? And he's doing nothing. God led them into a trap purposefully. Because it was the planting of the seed.
Amen.
Hallelujah. What was going to come out of there was even going to be multiplied and greater than what went down.
Yes.
Is it? He brings them, left his people with no retreat. Sometimes he does that. Let the doctor walk away and say, you aren't going to live. You are going to die. That cancer is going to kill you. You will never get up out of that chair. He seems like he leaves you with no retreat. But he is your retreat. Hallelujah. Climb back into his arms. God is my refuge. He's my mighty tower. The name of the Lord is a mighty tower. The righteous run into it and are saved. The tower of refuge, he is our refuge, and no refuge I have but him. I don't want to know any other refuge. He's my refuge. He's a rock in a weary land, a shelter in the time of need. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So children of God, when you are traveling in the weary lands, you must know that he's the rock.
Amen.
Hallelujah. When you have when you need shelter in time of need, he's your shelter. Hallelujah. So the Lord should bless you. Let us always remember that.
Amen.
We are sustained by the goodness of God.
Amen.
Remember where you come from. Remember how your life has changed before you became a Christian, and you take courage from that.
Amen.
Because the devil has tendencies of coming to our lives and say, the God that we serve, it looks like he doesn't love you anymore. Eh? Look, this is happening, this has happened, and you should sequence and sense of things and events that happened in your life.
Amen.
And you want to make you lose faith in God. Hallelujah. And it doesn't start with us. He did that with Brother Brennan. I mean, he came to Brother Brennan and he showed his sense and suitcase of things that happened. Just know that there's nothing that lasts forever. Everything is unlimited. Hallelujah. So even your challenges that are time limited.
Yes.
Hallelujah. They have to come through the flesh. There's no other way. He has to punish the flesh. But as he punishes the flesh, remember now it's for the purpose of your soul. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God bless you as you call Brother Ibu.
Hallelujah.